The fish ladder at the Nimbus Fish Hatchery is now open. At 7:30 this morning, the hatchery officials raised the gate. The salmon climbed the ladder toward the agency's holding tanks. Now, on a normal year, more than 8,000 fish climb the ladder. The hatchery needs 8 million eggs to meet their goal of 4 million fish. The salmon run is already behind schedule, and fewer fish are making the return trip. Nimbus is not the only hatchery concerned about the spawners.
You know, up and down the other hatcheries in the Central Valley are experiencing low runs of Chinook salmon. And so I'm still optimistic that we will meet our mitigation goals.
Warmer river water and weather could be contributing to the lower numbers. Fishermen have seen the decline firsthand. But as our Brian Hickey reports, biologists say this could still end up being a normal but later salmon run.
Ask any fisherman about the fall salmon run, and you'll likely hear about the
the lack of.
From the ocean to the lower American, they're all asking the same question. Where's the fish?
It's hard to figure. I've been doing this since I was in my 20s, and this is the worst year I've seen.
But you keep on trying, huh?
Oh, yeah. It's the anticipation.
They're not the only ones waiting and wondering.
We don't have a real good feel yet for how large the run's going to end up being.
The Nimbus Fish Hatchery is opening the fish ladder today, though they don't expect a whole lot of fish. Not yet, anyway.
It looks like last year, we've got a late run.
It's believed the fish are holding in the delta, waiting for cooler water to invite them up the lower American.
The water temperature's down about 60 degrees, according to my temp on the gauge, but it's not the quantity.
58 degrees seems to be the magic number.
It has in the past. We see a really proximate relationship between the water temperature dropping below 60 and spawning activity in the river, and including in the hatchery.
Starting Friday, fish and game will cool the river down, tapping into colder water at the bottom of Folsom Lake. But to do that, they have to shut down the power generators at a cost of $250,000. Terry will be waiting.
What do they say about a bad day of fishing?
Better than a good day of work.
In Sacramento, Brian Hickey, KCRA 3 reports.